So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIP 24/7. मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू सम मोर इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस सम मोर इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज़ फ्रॉम द पीआईबी. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन एंड ऑल्सो यू कैन ज्वाइन आवर टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस. राइट, सो नाउ लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन. सो yes, so in today's session guys we are going to discuss these four news. So these are the four news for the today's session. Number one, there is a loan that has been given by Asian Development Bank for the Delhi Meerut RRTS corridor. Number two, we are going to discuss about the Hunar Haat, and then we will move on to the MOU that has been signed between CSIR, CMERI and NISE, and finally we are going to discuss about the National Bamboo Mission. और ये बेसिकली नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन हम इसलिए पढ़ रहे हैं बिकॉज रिसेंटली जो मिनिस्टर हैं ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर उन्होंने ये बताया है दैट नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन इज मेकिंग सम प्रोग्रेस. सो उसके प्रोग्रेस के बारे में बताया है. सो दैट्स व्हाई वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेशन गाइज विद क्वेश्चन नंबर वन विच इज अबाउट द लोन दैट हैज बीन साइंड बिटवीन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक. सो द क्वेश्चन इज दिस लोन has been signed for the development of Delhi-Meerut RRTS corridor. With respect to the loan sanctioned, we have to identify the correct statement. All right, we have to identify the correct statement with respect to the loan jo ki sanction kiya gaya hai. So let us discuss this news guys. One second. Yes. So recently guys, $500 million ka loan has been signed between Asian Development Bank and the Government of India for this Delhi-Meerut RRTS corridor. And what is the meaning of RRTS? RRTS stands for Rapid Transit System Corridor. Okay, Regional Rapid Transit System Corridor. Regional Rapid Transit System RRTS corridor. Delhi-Meerut के बीच में जो कि बनाया जाएगा, जिससे जो Delhi-Meerut के बीच का जो gap है, जो कि आने जाने में जो time लगता है, that will be reduced very much. Okay. And remember this, that this $500 million is the first tranche of $1 billion facility जो कि प्रॉमिस किया गया है बाय द एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक दैट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट गाइस ऑब्जेक्टिव, सो व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लोन? सो इट विल प्रोवाइड बेटर कनेक्टिविटी इन द एनसीआर रीजन. कनेक्टिविटी बढ़ेगी क्योंकि जब दिल्ली से मेरठ कम टाइम में हम जा पाएंगे सो सभी को बेनिफिट होगा, कनेक्टिविटी बढ़ेगी. इट विल ईज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन प्रेशर ऑन दिल्ली बिकॉज दिल्ली के अंदर काफी ज्यादा ट्रैफिक होता है. सो दिस project will ease the concentration pressure on Delhi and it will also improve the regional connectivity and mobility across the NCR region. Of course guys, agar Delhi aur Meerut ke beech mein koi regional rapid transit system banaya jayega then it will definitely improve the regional connectivity and mobility across the NCR region because Meerut also comes under the NCR region. And this corridor guys will connect Sarai Kale Khan in Delhi to Modipuram in Meerut. Sarai Kale Khan ek place hai in New Delhi. This corridor will connect Sarai Kale Khan to Modipuram which is in Meerut and Meerut we all know is in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, jo high speed iske andar attain hogi that will be 180 km per hour. The highest speed will be 180 km per hour and the total length of this corridor will be 82 km. All right, and these are some other loans that were given by ADB in the recent past. Like for example, ADB has provided $1.5 billion loan to fight COVID-19 infection. Other than this, $490 million for upgradation of roads of Madhya Pradesh. जो मध्य प्रदेश के state highways हैं, उनको improve करने के लिए the loan was provided of $490 million. And इसके अलावा $177 million was provided for the upgradation of Maharashtra state highways. महाराष्ट्र के roads को upgrade करने के लिए $177 million loan provide कराया गया है. Guys, loan से question can be asked in the RBI phase 1 and also it can be asked in the ESI section also. So jitne bhi loans ke questions hai, you have to prepare it properly. And guys, if you talk about Asian Development Bank, so it was established in the year 1966. It is headquartered in Manila is in Philippines, right? It is in Philippines. And recently Masatsugu Asakawa has became the chairperson of ADB. And the recent past, जो अशोक लवासा है, अशोक लवासा who was earlier the election commissioner of India has made the vice president of Asian Development Bank. अशोक लवासा को vice president बना दिया गया है of the Asian Development Bank. So अशोक लवासा की जगह election commissioner किनको बनाया गया है? He is Mr. राजीव कुमार. राजीव कुमार इज द न्यू इलेक्शन कमिश्नर. सो इन इंडिया गाइस चीफ इलेक्शन कमिश्नर करेंटली सुनील अरोड़ा. एंड इन इंडिया चीफ इलेक्शन कमिश्नर इज असिस्टेड बाय टू इलेक्शन कमिश्नर्स, वेयर टू इलेक्शन कमिश्नर्स करेंटली आर, वन इज मिस्टर राजीव कुमार हु इज न्यूली अपॉइंटेड, एंड वन इज मिस्टर सुशील चंद्र. सो दीज आर द टू इलेक्शन कमिश्नर्स, एंड द चीफ इलेक्शन कमिश्नर इज सुनील अरोड़ा. अशोक लवासा हैज मेड द वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक रिसेंटली. ओके, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन. सो व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द लोन सैंक्शन, वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. ओके, सो द लोन अमाउंट इज हाउ मच? $750 million? नो, इट इज $500 million, एंड इट इज द फर्स्ट ट्रांच ऑफ द $1 billion दैट इज प्रॉमिस्ड बाय एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक. And it is the first tranche of $1 billion loan facility. Yes, this is absolutely correct. So we have to find the correct statement. Therefore, option B will be the correct answer to this question. Okay. And now let's move on to the question number 2, which is about the Hunar Haat. So guys, question number 2 is about the Hunar Haat. So the question is, with respect to the Hunar Haat that is going to be restarted after a gap of 6 months, we have to find the incorrect statement. Okay. So we have to find the incorrect statement with respect to the Hunar Haat. So let us discuss this. So this was it was in news. Hunar Haat was in news because after a gap of 6 months because of coronavirus, it is again restarting from the month of October on the date 9th of October 2020. And this time, jo next Hunar Haat hone wala hai, starting from 9th of October 2020, that is to be organized in Prayagraj. Kahan pe hoga guys ye? Prayagraj mein. Alright, that is to be organized in Prayagraj after a gap of 6 months. And this time Hunar Haat will focus on indigenously made toys. जो हमारे देश में बने हुए toys हैं उनके ऊपर focus किया जाएगा in this Hunar Haat. And now these are some key points. So it will be organized in Prayagraj with the theme of local to global. Guys, this is very important. You should remember the theme of this Hunar Haat, जो कि Prayagraj में start होने वाला है. Local to global is the theme. So and what will it do? It will provide a market and opportunities to the artisans who prepare indigenous toys. ठीक है, जो indigenous toys बनाने वाले artisan है उनको एक market provide कराएगा, एक opportunity provide कराएगा to sell their products. Okay. And the very important thing is that this time people will be able to buy the Hunar Haat products online also. इस बार जो है वो online भी कोई भी person Hunar Haat के products को online खरीद सकता है. People will also be able to buy the Hunar Haat products online, and Hunar Haat has provided employment and employment opportunities to more than 5 lakh Indian artisans as quoted by the Ministry of Minority Affairs. And Ministry of Minority Affairs guys is headed by Mr. Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Okay, and this Hunar Haat, if we talk about, so ye basically hota kya hai, ye exhibition hota hai handicrafts ka, aur jo purane hamare heritage art and craft hai unka ye heritage hota hai. और ये स्पेशली किसके लिए, किन के लिए अरेंज किया जाता है? फॉर द माइनॉरिटी अफेयर्स. ये केवल जो माइनॉरिटी कम्युनिटीज हैं केवल उनके लिए ही अरेंज किया जाता है. सो इट इज एन एग्जीबिशन ऑफ हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स एंड ट्रेडिशनल प्रोडक्ट्स विच आर मेड बाय माइनॉरिटीज. सो दीज आर द एग्जीबिशंस ऑफ दोज प्रोडक्ट्स विच आर मेड बाय माइनॉरिटीज ओनली, एंड इट इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ माइनॉरिटी अफेयर्स अंडर अ स्कीम विच इज नोन एज उस्ताद स्कीम. ओके, उस्ताद स्कीम के अंडर इसको ऑर्गेनाइज कराया जाता है. And what is the full form of Ustad? Upgrading the skills and training traditional arts and crafts for the development. Okay, so you should remember the full form of the Ustad, because abhi iski baat chali hai to Ustad ka question pucha ja sakta hai. And what it does? It promotes the promotes and preserve the heritage of arts and crafts of the minority communities and provide them proper market access so that they can sell out their products properly. Okay, so this is about the Hunar Haat guys. Now let's move on to the question. Question is what? We have to find the incorrect statements. Okay, so the statement number 1 is it is organized by Ministry of Tourism and Culture. No, it is organized by Ministry of Minority Affairs because it is exclusively for the products of minority communities. Okay, the next Hunar Haat will be organized in Delhi. No, it will be organized in Prayagraj from 9th of October to 18th of October 2020. And the theme of next Hunar Haat will be local for global. Yes, this is absolutely correct. So स्टेटमेंट 3 हमारा केवल करेक्ट है, एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. सो ऑप्शन बी ओनली 1 and 2 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ओके, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन गाइस. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट द एमओयू दैट हैज बीन साइंड बिटवीन सीएसआईआर सिमेरी, एंड द क्वेश्चन इज दिस एमओयू हैज बीन साइंड बिटवीन विच टू ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. वन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज गिवन सीएसआईआर सीएमईआरआई, and which organization for giving a boost to the solar energy sector across the nation? Okay, so I hope the question is clear. The question is asking for the other organization. One organization is CSIR, CMERI. Okay, so guys, let's discuss about this news. So recently an MOU has been signed between these two organizations, which are CSIR, CMERI and NISE, which is in Gurugram. Okay, NISE stands for National Institute of Solar Energy, and apne CSIR, CMERI ka naam zarur suna hoga. Humne recently padha tha that in the campus of CMERI, world's largest solar tree was installed recently, alright, in the campus of CMERI Durgapur, alright. So अब recently CSIR, CMERI और NISE में, इन दोनों organizations में, दोनों institutes के बीच में MOU हुआ है to give a boost to the solar energy sector across the nation. पूरे देश में solar energy sector को boost provide कराने के लिए this MOU has been signed between these two organizations, and these are some objectives. ये सारे objectives आपको याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, these are very basic. और ये एग्जाम में नहीं पूछा जाएगा, यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेम्बर द एमओयू, किन दो ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, किन दो इंस्टीट्यूट्स के बीच में हुआ है, एंड व्हाट इज द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द एमओयू, एंड द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव वाज व्हाट इज व्हाट टू बूस्ट द सोलर एनर्जी सेक्टर अक्रॉस द कंट्री, एंड दीज आर सम अदर ऑब्जेक्टिव लाइक कंडक्टिंग जॉइंट फील्ड स्टडीज फॉर डिफरेंट सोलर टेक्नोलॉजीज, स्किल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ स्टेक होल्डर्स विच आर रिलेटेड टू द सोलर सेक्टर, carrying out policy and regulatory studies dealing with grid integration, recycling and disposal of solar panels, to collaborate with international level research institutions for greater research and development, and joint working towards enhancing and expanding the capability, facility and infrastructure in the solar energy sector. Right, so these are some objectives. ये सारे आपको याद रखने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, these are very, you know, इस तरीके का question exam में नहीं आता, that what are the objectives of the MOU, in detail इतना नहीं पूछा जाता, okay. And these are some renewable energy targets. I hope आपको ये सारे targets पता हैं. So we have to achieve a target of 175 gigawatt by the year 2022 in overall renewable energy. While out of this 175, 100 gigawatt should be from the solar energy, 60 gigawatt from wind energy, 10 gigawatt from biomass, and 5 gigawatt from small hydropower plants. Okay, so these are the targets that India has to achieve by the year 2020. Okay. And now let's come back to the question. Question is, an MOU has been signed between which organization? So one organization is CSIR, CMERI, and other organization is National Institute of Solar Energy, which is located in Gurugram. And Gurugram mein International Solar Alliance ka bhi headquarter hai. Okay. Remember this, in Gurugram, we have the headquarter of Solar Alliance, and for formation of International Solar Alliance, Pradhan Mantri Modi, Narendra Modi, and the French President Emmanuel Macron have got the Champions of the Earth award. Okay, and now let's move on to question number 4 and 5, which is about the National Bamboo Mission. So guys, question number 4 and 5 is about the National Bamboo Mission. Let us first discuss the news, that what is the news. So recently guys, the Union Agriculture Minister, who is Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, has inaugurated 22 bamboo clusters in 9 states and a new logo of the National Bamboo Mission. Bamboo को गवर्नमेंट द्वारा कहा गया था ग्रीन गोल्ड. ओके, इन 2018 व्हेन द रीस्ट्रक्चर नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन वाज लॉन्च, गवर्नमेंट कॉल्ड इट एज अ ग्रीन गोल्ड. ओके, सो नया लोगो नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन का लॉन्च किया गया है. इसके अलावा 22 बैम्बू क्लस्टर्स इन 9 स्टेट्स हैव बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द यूनियन एग्रीकल्चरल मिनिस्टर. ओके, बट बिफोर मूविंग टू द प्रोग्रेस मेड इन दिस मिशन, लेट अस फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन. सो इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2006-07 एज अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम अंडर मिशन फॉर इंटीग्रेटेड डेवलपमेंट फॉर हॉर्टिकल्चर. इसको बाद में सब्स्यूम कर दिया गया था अंडर मिशन फॉर इंटीग्रेटेड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर. कब? ड्यूरिंग 2014-15, और इसको कंटिन्यू करा कब तक? 2015-16 तक. राइट, सो इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2006-07 बट वॉज सब्स्यूम अंडर द मिशन फॉर इंटीग्रेटेड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 2014-15 टिल 2015-16. ओके, इसको यहाँ पे फिर खत्म कर दिया गया. उसके बाद the restructured national bamboo mission was approved in the year 2018 for implementation till the financial year 2020. financial year 2020 tak ke liye isko approve kar diya gaya as the restructured national bamboo mission. aur ye jo restructured national bamboo mission tha, it acts as a sub scheme of national mission on sustainable agriculture. okay, under another umbrella scheme which is known as krishon krishonnati yojana. okay, So this scheme, National Restructured National Bamboo Mission, was under National Mission on Sustainable Agriculture, which is under the umbrella scheme Krishonati Yojana. Okay. And what are the objectives of this scheme, Restructured National Bamboo Mission? So to increase the area under bamboo plantation in the non-forest, government and private lands, bamboo plantation ke area ko badhana, to rejuvenate the underdeveloped bamboo industry in India. And remember this guys, India is the second largest producer of the bamboo after China in the world. To promote skill development, capacity building, awareness generation for development of bamboo sector. Basically hame karna kya hai, jo bamboo ka sector hai usko develop karna hai har sphere mein, uski exports ko badhana hai. Abhi hum itne acche tarike se export nahi kar rahe hain, in fact we are importing right now. So agar hame net ke case mein dekhe to we are the net importer of bamboo, but abhi recently jo minister of agriculture hai unhone bola hai that we are now in a situation of exporting the bamboo in a large scale. Okay, so these were some objectives, and once again, and this is the funding pattern. What is the funding pattern? So 60:40 between the center and states, 90:10 between center and northeastern and hilly states, and 100% for UTs by the center. So this is very general funding pattern. Most of the schemes mein yahi wala funding pattern follow kiya jata hai by the government of India. And guys, this is the new logo of the National Bamboo Mission. This is the new logo, and the winner of this logo design is Mr. Sri Sai Ram Gowdi Adigi of Telangana. He was the winner of this logo design. Ye aapko naam yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai, but yes, agar ho jata hai then that is well and good, because nobody knows ki question kahan se pucha jayega. So the winner of this logo design is Mr. Sri Sai Ram Gowdi Adigi of Telangana, and iske andar jo green aur yellow color hai symbolizes bamboo, often termed as the green gold. Okay, so this is the new logo, which is designed by Sri Sai Ram Gowdi Adigi of Telangana. All right. And now what are the progresses that have been made till now under this mission? So this bamboo ecosystem guys has now been energized with 23 states, including all the states of the northeast. Northeast ke jitne bhi states hain un sabhi tak is scheme ko, is national bamboo mission ko energize kar diya gaya hai, aur in total there are 23 states jahan pe scheme ko energize kiya gaya, jahan pe scheme ko phailaya ja chuka hai. Okay, and isme jo 10 most important species hote hain of the bamboo plant, उसको आइडेंटिफाई किया गया है बाय द गवर्नमेंट, और उसकी और मतलब ऐसे स्पीशीज जो कि मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर में काफी ज्यादा रोल प्ले करते हैं, ऐसे स्पीशीज को आइडेंटिफाई किया गया बाय द गवर्नमेंट, एंड दीज 10 इंपॉर्टेंट स्पीशीज आर नाउ प्रोवाइडेड टू द मैन्युफैक्चरर्स एंड द फार्मर्स. ओके, सो दीज 10 मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्पीशीज आर विच आर रिक्वायर्ड बाय इंडस्ट्री हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड, एंड क्वालिटी प्लांटिंग मटीरियल आर बीइंग मेड अवेलेबल टू द फार्मर्स फॉर प्लांटेशंस. ओके, and Assam has already engaged farmer producer organizations for raising plantations. And iske alawa abhi aapne suna hoga that there was a new scheme jiske andar 10,000 farmer producer organization banai jayenge in the 5 years. So ye jo FPOs honge wo related also honge also to the bamboo sector. Okay, to ye jo FPOs hai 10,000, iske andar bamboo sector se related farmer producer organizations bhi banai jayengi in the upcoming 5 years. Okay, so these are some progress that has been made under this mission, National Bamboo Mission, and this has been quoted by the Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Narendra Singh Tomar. Okay, and now let's move on to question number 4 and 5. So what is the question number 4? With respect to the mission, identify the correct statements. So it was launched in the year 2018. Yes, no, it was not launched in the year 2018. In fact, it was launched in the year 2006-7. The restructured mission was launched in the year 2018. Okay, it is currently being implemented under National Mission on Sustainable Agriculture. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And it has an objective to rejuvenate the underdeveloped bamboo industry in India. Yes, this is also correct. So therefore, the correct answer should be what? Option D, only 2 and 3. And question number 5. Identify the incorrect statement with respect to the progress made under the National Bamboo Mission. So all the northeastern states are now covered under this mission. Yes, all the 8 northeastern states, and in total 23 states are now being covered under this scheme. Assam has already engaged FPOs for raising plantations. This is also correct. And 10 most important species are being made available to the farmers for plantation, and these are the species which are very important for the manufacturing sector. Okay, so guys, all of these statements are absolutely correct. So option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer. Okay, and that's it for the session today. I hope you like it, and for more updates do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Aapko ye session kaisa laga comment karke zarur bataye. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.